first time I've seen snow. I am used to warm climates, and this is quite exciting for me. I'm from Aruba.
This field trip fits into our curriculum because we want the students to learn how sport is organized throughout the world. And this specific area here, Lausanne region, is where you find most of the international federations. So you really get to know these people, you really get to know these federations and all companies involved, and you really have the opportunity to understand the profession of a sport manager.
No man, I've never seen this before. I've never been in the mountains.
So this is all new. So excited, my heart is pounding right now, with no idea.
All the potatoes. Do you have the potatoes?
And whatever comes our way, yeah, darling, go make it happen. Take the world in a loving embrace. Fire all of your guns and bombs and explode into space.
I like smoke and lightning,
heavy metal thunder,
racing with the wind.
A lovely island called St. Martin in the Caribbean. Yeah, yeah.
I'm from France, from Strasbourg.
I'm from Holland. Lived there basically all my life, except for the past 5 year winter seasons. I've been just around here over the mountain.
I'm British. I grew up in Maidstone in Kent.
I come from Tallinn, Estonia.
I'm Dutch.
I'm from China.
So I want to be a leader in the field of sports.
Me and Sky are the first two Chinese students in ISMB.
There's lots of different nationalities here and I don't understand everyone, but it's gotta be better.
And I chose ISMB because I'm passionate about sports and I always wanted to study something connected to it, but there are no opportunities in my home country.
There is no education system like in the Netherlands. It's not that focused on sport. I really wanted to practice more, so I applied for ISMB.
Well, I figured I need to get serious at some point in my life, and the ISMB program, especially all the internships, I really like that aspect of it.
I like to go to Italy to go to work in my favorite basketball team in the Serie A Varese.
I love the fact that there's so many different nationalities in a classroom.
I'm Dutch, but my parents are from the Congo. So I'm multilingually raised, and that's one of my reasons why I choose ISMB, because I think I want to explore myself more in the international world.
You have 40 different nationalities in a classroom, you can have a lot of different perspectives.
Doing ISMB, I can get myself further in the football world and probably be one of the girls that changes the football world the way it is now.
So if you have all the theoretical information but you don't know how to use it, you're not really useful to a company.
So about 1 in 3 use a bike at least once a week in the world. So it's a massive industry. The BMX ones, for example, the young guys, they're so on their technology. They're always on their mobile phones.
One of the mistakes that young students in sports do very often is when I ask, why do you want to work for UEFA? Why do you want to work for FIFA? They say, because I'm passionate about football. It's difficult when you're 20, 25 to know exactly, you can know the relationship between, I don't know, sponsors, television, whatever. But that should be your aim. So I would say it's a successful event, you can see it before it happens. It's the planning. So if your event is well planned, already now for Thursday, it should look good. It should look like it's in place. There should be no panic. There should be no. Oh, you start today, okay. So plan, no, but plan.
Let's go, Ricardo!
Gloria's doing anything but slow down right now.
It was really nice, incredible experience, yeah, especially on the tour.
I've never done this before.
Can't do this. And this week comes in, it's like, you got this. And then you just...
It's pretty amazing, actually. It's really crazy.
This is what I expected for college, because sometimes you go to this college and you're studying books. But it's nice to go outside and build a sense of family and have a sense of fun. This is what you should be doing. You know, this makes you more motivated to do more.
Yeah,
this relived my hopes. This revitalized my dreams. So I love this.
I'm born and raised in Germany, but my parents are from Poland, so I have Polish blood in me. I have a Dutch nationality with Surinamese roots. I chose ISMB because I wanted to study with people from various backgrounds. Don't feel homesick because my family's over here. It's one of the reasons why I chose ISMB, because it offered those internships. I think right now, if I had to say it, it would be London, New York, and maybe Japan. But the people have the same soul, the same point of view, what we're doing here, and everyone is motivated, want to achieve the best. Because the ISMB program attracts a lot of students from abroad who come to Amsterdam just to study here. So you also get to meet them, so it's basically also like living abroad. Some students from the university, local university here, are participating in our event, so I hope we organize a successful event. So that's for the coming days. So from top to bottom, we have to organize the whole thing.
You never know what's going to happen on an event or, let's say, a field trip like this. You know, we can't predict the weather. We can't control what's going to happen with the bus. We have to just think on our feet. And I think we've also, as teachers, shown the students what's necessary to pull off an event with lots of people. And that you have to adapt and be flexible to what happens at that moment and think of, well, let's say, an advanced plan B and plan C.
It's a good way of education in the field trip because you can see the students working with each other in the different groups when they have different assignments or different things to do.
And being 24/7 with a group of students, you get to know them from a different angle than only just teaching.
And it's a very good way to see how that process is actually going, how the students are working with each other. You can reflect on that, give feedback on that.
It's an experience for them, the first time they have actually with the international working field, but now to see it in practice and that they hear it from the people from the work field as what we have taught, I think is very beneficial.
So any event, not just the Olympics, but the lowest level of event, they have to submit a water quality test based on different standards, E. coli and different bacteria. If it's over the limit, then either they have to relocate the swim.
Armenia was one of those situations where we had every so many bouts. So a bout is a boxing match, if you want. We need to change the gloves. So we have volunteers. We came to the quarterfinals. We only had 7 pairs of blue and 7 pairs of red left. It's like, what happened to the gloves? And you look outside, this huge stadium, stairs are like a kilometer away, you see the kids with the gloves in their pockets, you know? And they're like, okay, now what do we do? It's just a different mentality over there. They don't have any, I mean, it's a poor country who has problems, war with different countries. We had Azerbaijan and Armenia, they hate each other. It's how you look at things, how you approach things, you know? So yeah, things like that, that's how you would approach it. Just listen, and really open-minded and careful. You know, you can only make your first impression once.
It's hard work. I didn't expect that. It's difficult sometimes, and especially working in a group.
I learned a lot. I got to know something that I never seen or never heard of.
I already have in mind what I want to do for internships, yes. This year I'm going to try to gain one at FIFA, a stage at FIFA or whatever.
When you take the decision around the age of 17 or 18 or 19 to quit your country, to stay in a complete other culture for 4 years, being on your own, another culture, taking care of your own business, besides studying, from time to time you really need to be together. So it's not only about the product, it's about the process. Unfortunately, it's misty now, but there's a huge summit over there. It's not about how the summit looks like. That's a dream, but it's about how you will reach to that summit.
We're gonna run an event, so that's gonna be fun. I'm handling badminton, and yeah, luckily that will go smoothly.
One of our speakers, Sebastian, used to work for the UEFA. He talked to them about the importance of planning in terms of events. It's the most important thing that you need to think about. And that was sort of like a moment of eureka moment, effectively, for the students. And that evening, you could see just a change in them in terms of the way they were thinking and the way they went about sort of putting the plan in place for the event. It was almost like a light that turned on.
I just want quickly a couple small reactions from the group. And it would be nice if there are some Lausanne students who would like to say something about their participating in this tournament today.
And we came, we won, and that's it.
The organization, we put so much effort, and I think it was a really good tournament. And we didn't win, but the participation is also important.
You're seriously filming now?
Yes.
It's not my prettiest moment.
It was a really nice week.
Fantastic and tiring. Did great.
Yeah. It was really fun. It was really fun. Yeah.
I'm really happy to be with ISMB.
The whole group and myself, I think it was a real eye opener. I learned a lot, especially from all the group assignments.
I learned that sport was more than just sport, that it's actually very complicated if you look at all the different strategies that are used.
I'm really happy that we could organize this event.
Very interesting to see like all the organizations who made time for us.
Brilliant.
I've learned how to handle things when they go wrong.
Just always stay honest. Make sure you're prepared for interviews and that kind of stuff.
Learn how to work in a team.
Don't bullshit.
And I think we as a class got to know each other a lot better.
And they're pretty important people that also came to talk to us, like the marketing director or commerce director, that kind of stuff.
A lot of teamwork, mostly like communication between other groups.
Got a lot of business cards as well.
The UEFA was pretty high up.
Oh, about networking, that you need to network, that was the biggest.
Sometimes it's like a roller coaster because seriously, it's like a roller coaster because sometimes you are down, you are tired, have a serious conversation with your teammates. Sometimes you cannot understand each other, but after, when you can organize such a beautiful event like this, and we are Games 2014, you just realize that it worth it. Like that the effort that you put in it, like worth. And this is the good thing. And yeah, so thank you very much.
Get your motor running. Head out on the highway. Looking for adventure. And whatever comes our way. Yeah, darling, go make it happen. Take the world in a loving embrace. Fire all of your guns and pumps and explode into space.
I like smoking lightning.
Heavy metal thunder.
Racing with the